Hi everybody. Today's video is going to be just a little chit-chat about what I have been doing to organize the books on my bookcase. As you can see right here in front of me is a pile of books that my dad and stepmom just recently gave to Jimmy and I, and or Jimmy and me. And I today spent most of the day organizing and compiling books into different piles as to the books that I was going to keep and the books that I was going to give away and the books that I was going to use as gifts. So I've got a few piles together and I'm going to go over those with you. And this pile that we're looking at right now, we were just given, and I think I'm going to keep these. These are kind of reference books, but haven't had them for a while, and I haven't really had the opportunity to go through them. So I'm going to definitely hang on to those, and they will be placed upon my bookcase. And I will take you to that bookcase also in just a moment. Now, my room is really, really messy because I have been going through all these piles of books today, and it's just craziness. So this next pile that we're looking at right here is quite a large pile, and this pile, there's two piles in fact, are going to be books that I will be keeping and organizing on my bookcase. The books here are a collection of a lot of different things. At the moment, they are in no rhyme or reason for an order, but this particular book right here, The Magic Years, I've had this for a really long time. My dad gave this to me when I was a young mom raising my kids and they were little, and my oldest is going to be 18 now, and I have a granddaughter who's 3, so I don't particularly need this book to learn from reference. It would be a good book to share with my daughter who is raising my granddaughter right now, but I'm going to hang on to it because it was a gift from my dad. And then I just have a bunch of other random books, some reference books, some crafty type books, some decorating books. Over here are some really good ones that I am really enjoying. Natural cleaning for your home, bath and beauty, natural beauty at home. And I've mentioned before, I've done some videos where I have shared with you some of my books that I was currently going through at that particular time, and I'm just really an avid book lover. I love having my own home library. And one of the things that I have decided that I'm going to do this year in 2014 is I am going to be spending less time on my computer, and a lot of the time that I spend is basically in regard to my work, in marketing myself and the products that I create and put on my websites, but and also blogging and things to that nature. But I really feel that I spend a lot of time on YouTube watching videos while I'm just sitting down and not even being creative. So I think I'm going to change that up a little bit, and I'm going to bring my new studio has been moved this year as well, and I'm going to be bringing my computer up to my studio room, so while I'm creating, I'll be able to get through all the videos of the subscriptions that I really enjoy watching. But in the meantime, I've really decided, since I've gone through all these books, that I definitely, definitely want to start reading more in 2014. I'm going to make that a definite priority. This pile right here, and let me get these shoes out of the way, is a collection of books that I will be gifting at different points in time to different people, depending on the occasion and depending on the person. So I'm really excited about that because my books I keep in such good shape. They're basically all brand new. And oh, real quick, hi, Mr. Jackson. Say hi. Jackson. Hi. Hi, Jackson. Yeah, we're doing a video. Yes. And you are in it. You are in it. That's Mr. Jackson, everybody. And moving right along, I'm in my bedroom right now, if you haven't been able to tell that. But this pile right here is a collection of books that I have chosen to keep by my bedside. And I really want to try to, another thing is, have a better sleep schedule in the year of 2014 and get a lot of rest to keep my creativity level where it needs to be. And so one of the things I'm planning on doing would be coming up, and I'm going to turn this light on to see if that helps a little bit better. That might be too bright. Hopefully not. But anyways, to come up to bed a little bit earlier and just sit up in bed and read. And some of the books that I have chosen to put by my bedside table are, these are just daily, not scriptures. They're not scriptures, but they're just daily affirmations of things to remind you that you should always look at positive things and push the negative out, and each day is a brand new day kind of inspiration. And that's what this book is about. And then the next book here is The Business of Bliss, How to Profit from Doing What You Love. And I've read this before, but I would like to revisit this book to see if there's anything else that I could do to help with the things that I'm doing that I love, that I share with all of you, that could perhaps help me a little bit further along in my business this year. This next book is 101 Classic Love Poems, and I love reading poetry, so I thought that this would be a nice book to put by my bedside table. This is Summer's Cup. It says it's a scented potpourri of verse and prose. I've read through these books before as well, and just really, really nice poetry. There's a little bookmark. Just with pictures and just different stories and things, and I really like that. A Mystic Garden, Working with Soil and Attending to the Soul. This is a really cool book. I started reading this mid-year, and I am now back to January. And how it works is it takes you through the seasons. So basically, really winter is the beginning of the book. And we are now in winter, so I will be starting with that once again. And I really love it because it relates metaphorically how the garden relates to your soul. So it's really kind of cool. This next book is Romancing the Ordinary, A Year of Simple Splendor by Sarah Bond Brusnock. Sarah Bond Brusnock. She is one of my favorite authors. She has a collection of books that I have read, and I always revisit them. And this is a book that you also read monthly, and it starts with January, of course. So I will be beginning once again in January. And this particular book, as I said, is a monthly book. So it's a whole chapter for January, and then it moves on to each month, February, March, April, May, and so on. And then the last book here that I've got by my bedside is Simple Abundance, A Day Book of Comfort and Joy by Sarah Bond Brusnock. And this is her first book. And this one is a daily affirmation book. So I'm going to be back to January. And today is January 1st. And it says, a transformative year of delight and discovery. And so I will read that a little bit later on today. And so this book and the first one I shared with you are basically daily affirmation books that I will be looking through daily. And then there's one book that I just slipped back here that my friend Mary gave to me. I found tonight going through my books, and this is The Love Between Friends, and it is selected for Hallmark, and it is a collection of poetry, so really, really nice. That's a nice little gift that she had given me, and I want to keep that by my bedside table. So that is some of the books that I will be keeping in my room, and I just shut that light off, so excuse me, it's dark. And I'm going to move you over here. This is an entire stack of books that I have chosen to give either to the thrift store or another thing that I'm going to be planning and doing this particular year is spending time going to flea markets to try to sell some of the things that I have. We have a flea market here called Trader Jack's, and it's really, really kind of cool. So I'm going to do some of that and try to get rid of those books there, too, because they're, like I said, they're practically in brand new shape. Okay, and this right here is my lovely bookcase, and right now it is not organized at all. I just have the book sitting on it, so I'm going to bring you up once again. And I have some decorations here at the top on the bookcase. I'm just moving around a little bit here. And so this first shelf right here is basically going to be my fantasy shelf, where I have books of Lord of the Rings, the J.R.R. Tolkien collection, Return of the King, The Two Towers, Fellowship of the Ring. And then this one right here is all of the books put together. And I have Elf Realm, can't even talk today. Dune, this is Stephen King's Dreamcatcher. I have some Nancy Drew storybooks, which are really old, that I think we've had them forever. I have a couple Alice in Wonderland books. This is Alice in Wonderland, and then Alice Through the Looking Glass. I have The Secret Garden. Love this book. It is so amazing. Love it. I have the movie, too. It's just one of my favorites. And then I have it also in a soft cover. And then The Little Princess. This is another favorite of mine. And I think these are by, Francis Hodgson Burnett, these two particular books, The Secret Garden and The Little Princess. I have that movie as well. This is Anne of Green Gables. I think I found this one at a thrift store. And then I have some childhood books that I've kept with me for years. Aesop's Fables, The Real Mother Goose, which was mine when I was 3 years old. My mom and dad gave it to me. I have A Christmas Treasury, another Lord of the Rings, Making of the Movie Trilogy, The Velveteen Rabbit, and then Dragonology, which is a book that my mom gave to Jimmy. And then over here, these are, as I said, I have nothing in any particular order. Some ecology books. Well, this is How and Why Ecology book. Some calligraphy books. These are some of my favorite nature craft books, which, incidentally, The Captured Harvest, The Country Store, let's see, Nature Craft Techniques, etc. Oh, just really, really love those books. In fact, one of the things that I'm going to be doing this year in my business with MiladyLeela is I'm going to be doing a lot more artwork that encompasses nature, incorporating it into my jewelry, incorporating it into some of the other items, the whimsical things that I make. I'm really interested in starting to make some handmade paper, and I've got a lot of potpourri that I make that I think would be absolutely wonderful and perfect in making handmade papers, and I'll probably put those in my shop. And of course, we'll be doing our hand-poured and hand-dipped beeswax candles, too, this year. So there is a lot going on in the enchanting world of MiladyLeela. Over here, I have Holy Bible, and I have my Shabby Chic Rachel Ashwell books. And then down here is the continuation of my Victoria collection, A Shop of One's Own, Turn Your Passions into Profit. This is another favorite book of mine by Mary Emmerling, Romantic Country. This one belongs with my Shabby Chics, The Gift of Giving. This is such a good book. This is by Rachel Ashwell. And inside this book, it gives you such great ideas of putting really beautiful, different, and unique gifts together. And then down here I have the Ultimate Healing book, More Ultimate Healing, and the top 50 life-saving secrets of the world's greatest doctors. So these are some interesting books about homeopathic lifestyles and healing, and I'm really excited about going through that. So yes, I have a lot of books, and I am planning on organizing this bookcase. When it is all done, I will share that with you. maybe put it in a picture, attach the picture to this video. This is the side of the bookcase, and I just love it. Look how cute that is. It's just scrolly artwork. Just love it. So yeah, I'm really excited about 2014, getting back to organizing my personal library and sharing with you some more books in detail that I have read in the year of 2014. So stay tuned
for
that.
Okay, so I have finished organizing the bookcase, and I did share with you the top of it. I have it decorated with a few of my favorite things. And then moving down to the first shelf, I've included a couple of family photos. This is, it's really kind of hard to see here, but that is a photo of my grandparents. It's really difficult to see. That's a little bit better. And then my mom and dad on their wedding day. And I explained earlier that this is kind of the fantasy reading shelf with the Lord of the Rings trilogy books. And then I have some mystery books here and some old books that I had when I was a child. So that's the first shelf. The second shelf, I have put, I love this beautiful frame, and inside it is a velvet painting. It's kind of hard to see because there's a glare, but it's a velvet paint-by-number painting that I did when I was about 10 years old of a horse, and I just love that. And so I put that there. And then I have this wonderful tin right here, and inside it I have a collection of different matchbooks from places that we have been to. And this particular shelf houses all of my books that are recipe books or how-to type of books. So that's that shelf. And then the next shelf down is all of my decorating books, and including my decorating the garden, which I have a couple of books there. And on top of it, I have this box that looks like it was carved out of stone. Really kind of cool, just as an accent piece on the bookshelf. And then over here I have this, I don't really know what you would call it. It was once a container that housed perfume, my favorite perfume from Victoria's Secret, which is called Heavenly, and I've had it for years. I used up the perfume inside, but what I'm doing with it is I am beginning to see if I can open it up with one hand. Oh, I don't know if I can. Yeah, here we go. I am starting to create the inside. I'm going to bring it down so I can share it with you. I am, creating the inside so that it is going to be a dollhouse. And so far, I have wallpapered the walls, and I have made a couple of little carpets. These are zebra carpets that I made out of felt, and they're going to go on either side of the dollhouse. And then I found this package of mirrors. So I'm going to be designing the inside of this to make it a little dollhouse, probably a kind of like a dressing area vanity room inside there. So I just thought it looked really, really pretty on the shelf. And not only that, I'll be able to look at it daily, and it will inspire me to get back to work on that project. And then, oh, this goes back inside. There's some extra felt that belongs in there. No. And then down here on the bottom shelf are the books that I shared with you earlier in the video that were recently gifted from my dad and stepmom. And the first one I have here on top is Secrets of the Sea. And Secrets of the Seas. I cannot wait to look at that book because it has some beautiful glossy pictures of the ocean and the depths of the ocean. And then over here I just have some other random books that I had talked about earlier.
my a reading book, The Elephant Man, The Magic Years, a collection of poetry. I have Desperate Housewives, the Holy Bible, and my healing books. So that is the bookcase. I was going to take a picture of it for you all, but I thought it would be better to just go ahead and share it with you shelf by shelf. So once again, I really appreciate you watching this video. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today and going through this with me. I really appreciate you watching. Look for more to come in regard to the books that I will be reading in 2014. I'll be really excited to share those with you. And until next time, have a great day. Bye.